As we stay home and wait to explore the world around us again, we welcome you to join us on a virtual journey through the place we are proud to call home, Canada's beautiful West. Over the next weeks and months, we will explore the imposing and dramatic Canadian mountain ranges, the often tumultuous history of the railroad, the rich culture and practices of the region's Indigenous communities, as well as a closer look at the fascinating wildlife of the region, including our favorite, bears. We start with a journey through the magical mountains of Canada's West. Formed over a millennia, each of the Canadian mountains we pass have their own fascinating stories. We often start our journeys in Vancouver, and even from the heart of the city, you can see the awesome glacial peak of Mount Baker high above the clouds. World record-breaking Mount Baker is located in Washington State and is one of the icons of the Cascade Range. The Cascades are a volcanic range extending down to California and comprise the North American portion of the horseshoe-shaped Pacific Ring of Fire, a very seismic region. While Mount Baker is part of the Ring of Fire, it is more famous for its abundance of snow. In 1998 to 99, Mount Baker ski area set a world snowfall record with 29 meters or 95 feet of snow in just one season. From record depths of snow to camels, we arrive at the peculiarly named Jackass Mountain and the surprising story of camels in the Canadian Rockies. The mountain is named for the mule trails that ventured north to the Caribou Goldfields. The route was also known as the Hill of Despair because it was so narrow and steep that many mules slipped to their deaths. Transportation along the Caribou Road back then was very expensive, at about a dollar per pound. The mules they used could only carry about 250 pounds and walk around 25 kilometers or 15 miles per day. Frank Lomister and John Calbreth, two entrepreneurial businessmen, thought that camels might be better suited because they could carry triple the load and walk twice as far. So they purchased 23 double-humped camels for $300 each, and they were soon put to work hauling supplies along the Caribou Road. The peculiar odor of the camels was enough to send nearby horses and mules stampeding, and the camels' hooves were too soft for the rough, rocky terrain, leading to injury. The idea was abandoned, and the camels were sold or released into the surrounding hills, where they were spotted until the early 1900s. Mount Fitzwilliam and the first tourist to cross Canada. We have the pleasure of welcoming many visitors to the Canadian Rockies in luxury each year, but it hasn't always been that way. The first tourist to ever cross Canada, Milton and Cheadle, had a slightly less luxurious experience and endured many hardships along their journey. A nobleman and his personal doctor, the two were friends and in their early 20s. Their amazing adventure included wintering on the prairies and nearly starving to death along the North Thompson River. Their Indigenous guide, with his wife and son, took them to Kamloops. If you'd like to know what traveling through this land in 1863 was like, the two wrote a best-selling book about their trip called The Northwest Passage by Land. But this imposing massif of Mount Fitzwilliam, which rises 2,907 meters, was named in 1863 by Dr. Walter Butler Cheadle in honor of his traveling companion, William Wentworth Fitzwilliam, the Viscount Milton. The mountain's most distinctive aspect is the two-tone color scheme, dark at the top and light at the bottom. The lower half is made up of dolomite, whereas the upper half is made up of quartzite covered with lichen, giving it a dark gray color. The aptly named Castle Mountain was named by Dr. James Hector in 1857, noting that, quote, "It looks exactly like a gigantic castle." Very poetic. The lower cliff is dolomite, the middle ledge is shale, and the upper cliff is limestone. This rock was laid down in the sea during the middle of the Cambrian period, about 525 million years ago. In 1881, a man named Joe Healy received some silver-rich ore from the area in trade from an Indigenous person. The following year, he settled at Castle Mountain as a prospector. News of the silver spread fast, and others began to arrive. At its height, over 3,000 people lived here, but it was almost entirely abandoned by 1885, as the mines failed to yield significant profit. And some say the whole thing was a hoax. From 1946 to 1979, it was known as Mount Eisenhower, in honor of the World War II general and later President of the United States, Dwight D. Eisenhower. Many of the residents preferred the old name and pressured the federal government for many years to restore it, which they did in 1979. But in doing so, the tower-like southeast summit was named Eisenhower Peak. General Eisenhower was known to be fond of golf, and thus a smooth, grassy area below the peak is informally called Eisenhower Green. And finally, the impressive Mount Robson. The tallest mountain in the Canadian Rockies, Mount Robson, with an elevation of 3,954 meters, or 12,972 feet. Indigenous people in the area, Stonies or Shuswap, refer to Mount Robson as Yah-Hai-Has-Hun, meaning Mountain of the Spiral Road to the Afterlife. The origins of the modern name is unknown, but the Robson for whom the peak was named was most likely Colin Robertson, an officer of the Hudson's Bay Company in the Peace River area. In 1820, he sent a group of Iroquois fur scouts into this part of the Rockies, under the leadership of Ignace Jassen. In those days, names such as Robertson and Robinson were often mispronounced, sounding like Robson. It's possible Jassen chose to name the mountain for his boss. He may have told the group's guide, Pierre Hatzinaten, the famous Yellowhead, about the new name. Hatzinaten lived practically in the shadow of the mountain, and might have started referring to it as Robson, passing the new name on to others. At any rate, by 1827, the mountain was commonly known as Mount Robson. Mount Robson is a difficult and dangerous mountain to climb. It's big and it's steep, with notoriously bad weather and the constant risk of avalanche. It wasn't climbed until 1913, when a group from the Alpine Club of Canada, led by the great Austrian-Canadian guide Conrad Kane, made the first ascent. Mount Robson Provincial Park covers about 2,172 square kilometers, or 840 square miles. It lies along the BC-Alberta boundary, which is also the Continental Divide, bordered on the east by Jasper National Park. Mount Robson is included as a UNESCO World Heritage Site. We hope you enjoyed this relaxing distraction, a few surprising facts, and immersing for a moment in the shots and footage of Canada's most iconic sites, often referred to as nature's cathedrals, the majestic mountains of the Rockies. We hope you join us next time for a closer look at everyone's favorite resident of the Rockies, bears.